So it's almost 6 o'clock. I woke up by myself, and it's, I guess we're gonna have a sunrise very soon, and we're about to leave to pick up Tomek. So
let's see. I'm not sure how many people I managed to wake up with the anchor, but it's up and we're on the way. Let's see. Conception Island is right behind me. The most beautiful place in the Bahamas, at least the one we know of. And we're going from here to here, which is the Clarence Town in Long Island. And that's where we're going to pick up Tomek. We'll see. We'll raise sail soon. So, we're on the way. It was a beautiful sunrise, and now we have about, give or take, about between 15 and 20 knots of wind. It's very nice, very good sailing. Quite fast, and even though it's upwind, it's not exactly totally uncomfortable. Right? Men are indispensable.
Oh, I did two turns. Come on.
Change a little bit, so we're not sailing so upwind as we were sailing for last 3 hours. So it's getting easier with the waves. Yeah, and we got 30 miles to Dead Man's Key to Clarence Town. So we should be there in less than 2 hours. Yeah, we are arriving to Dead Man's Key to Clarence Town. Look at the colors. Can you ever get bored with that colors? I don't think so. Thank you.
We're gonna have a nice land-based meal, and we're gonna stuff ourselves because we were expecting to be at sea for three weeks and change to rescue Alex Doba on his kayak. But now it turns out we're not going there because there's a Spanish fishing vessel right next to him that's gonna help him. So we're staying here. We're just going to Dominican Republic.
Yes.
And cheers, we drink to Doba.
Anaconda!
Here on Deadman's Key, just in front of the marina we were yesterday. So the marina is just next to that church on the hills. Monster, I think it's like a lobster a few years ago. Look at what I just found. Yeah, these are sand dollars, but they are very fragile. They are so beautiful, look at it.
What's your name?
My name is Coco Loco.
Hi Coco Loco, nice to meet you.
So today we're going to go from Clarence Town, where we are right now, which is right here, and we're just going to go about 3 miles west, Dean's Blue Hole, which is supposed to be the deepest blue hole in the world, I think, about 600 feet, 200 meters, and that's where that's a dive site for apparently numerous freediving championships, world championships. So let's go and see. I think we've reached the little bay where supposed to be the Dean's Blue Hole, which is the 600 feet, 200 meter deep blue hole, just kind of out of the blue, literally, shaft going into the sand, into incredible depth. So we'll see, we'll go.
Some people didn't make it.
How deep can you dive?
Like 110.
110? How long does it take it?
like 3 and 10 seconds.
Are you crazy?
A little bit.
Where are you from?
Mexico.
Really? Crazy. 3.5 minutes under the water and 110 meter. Okay, I can spend 10 seconds. Okay, don't do it. You got a family. You got wife and 2 kids. And the crew on the boat.
We're here one day ever and we run into a guy who's holding a world record. It's like insane.
And he was very modest, too modest.
When I dove in there to about 20 meters and I looked up, I only saw a circle of light. Other than that, there was just darkness all around and silence. And even though it was a little bit scary, it was actually very, very peaceful. It was amazing.
Os segredos vêm da floresta de luz pra te amamar. Pra te amamar, abre a consciência dos seus filhos a crescer.